Man, I'm looking at 5/2. I mean, this deck, if you don't draw more than 3 lands, this deck can do that. It could just blow people out. Even on mulligan to 5. So this hand is not convincing, but I'm going to keep it. Let's see. Do we leave Bolt mana open? We want to. Yeah. The problem is I also want to keep this Catacombs for Lynx. So I think I just have to untap my Sacred Foundry. Sure, that's fine. I guess we're going to go with the Pride Mage. No interest in an 0-1 Tarmogoyf. He chose not to play a 1-drop on turn 1. That's pretty sick. Alright, what are we going to do? I don't know if that could be correct. Like, I get to keep my Bolt. You're just letting me keep my Bolt. Alright, we're going to attack for 3. I think we let him have his 1-drops now. And just play Goyf Nicatl, yeah. Yeah. So we need a green source off of this one. Could go ahead and be a forest, I think, yeah. Voice go. Yep, he's got a removal spell. So we can't use our Rampager unless it's reactive to the removal spell. So we want to be aware of that. If we just bolt one of his 1-drops, then our Goyf's a 3/4, and we can attack with the Cat and the Tarmogoyf, the Nicatl, that is, without using the Rampager. Actually, I also have to play this untapped Foundry, but that's probably fine. And then I'm just thinking, anything else matters in that situation? No, I don't think so. So let's bolt the... Bolt the Birds of Paradise because of Dismember. And I guess Red Cap. It's actually pretty relevant. It just dies. Okay, so it's probably Abrupt Decay. It's going to Abrupt Decay now on the Goyf. Yeah, okay. Interesting that he blocked. Three cards in hand. I'm actually just debating whether or not I should kill the Hierarch here. I think I should. I'm not 100% on that. Is this 16? Yeah, that's kind of tough. I think I better just pass. There's a chance the Hierarch is 100% irrelevant. Abrupt Decay, that's probably a bad sign. That means he's got a pod. Spellskite, alright. I guess I have to bolt now. I don't have to bolt now, actually, but maybe I should. No. Let's just Rampage the Nicatl through the Spellskite. Only problem there is if he doesn't block, which is actually realistic. And then I just have a dead bolt in my hand. So I guess we have to bolt the hierarch now, and it looks really stupid, but... And then just plays a land. Yeah, of course. Well played. I actually really needed a block here. Okay, cool. Pumps up my Goyf. Gets Spellskite off the table. Makes his elemental a 1-1. Witness for Abrupt Decay. Noble Hierarch. Yeah, you really did need that Noble Hierarch after all. He had mixed the elemental with 3-3 so he can trade with Goyf. He's at 12 right now. That's awkward. There's nothing I can really do about that. All I could do is wait and see if I draw something to interact. And the only way that actually works is if his last card and his next card are irrelevant. Yeah, it might be worth it. Of course, if he plays another creature, then the elemental gets bigger, and then we're in even worse shape. So, maybe we should attack. Yeah, I think we should attack. Interesting. It's very interesting. Based on how long I thought about that, he could have easily read me for nothing, but it might not have been worth the risk, and that's probably... Oh, yeah, he could also have Ravlark. In that case, it might have risked it. So, Witness and Spellskite. Witness gets back Abrupt Decay. That's a pretty good Ravlark, I'll admit that. What does he have now? Another 5 drop? Jeez. Yep, literally nothing I can do here. And I'm pretty sure that's not beatable. Let's also draw Birthing Pod. Alright then, so that's 3 matches here against Melira Pod, and I'm not sure my overall record in this, I think we played 5 total. The matchup seems reasonable, and this deck definitely needs some finalizing. So this deck is definitely something you need to be aware of though in the modern format. So that's it this week, guys. Thanks for watching, and look forward to more modern videos before the Pro Tour. See you then.